Once again, let me save just in case the game crashes or something. I doubt it will, but wait, did I just save? Yeah, I did. Okay. Alright, what am I gonna grab? I was in M4, right? Any more M4? Oh god, records office, more council crap. Yeah. Lineage Act Amendment, Jesus. I don't want to read that much of that. I'll grab some. Is there more? Unity Act, another one. Alright. Alright, how many are there from M4? I think I can get all the ones from M4 and get some others. Okay, yeah, I'll grab all the ones from M4, we'll get that over with. Oh god, they're all from the records office, and I will grab a couple more that are more interesting. This one looks interesting. This is from Kim So-yi, which I believe was the scientist, right? I think that was the scientist. Alright. Alright, let's do it. Actually, I wonder if I do have more power to extract more, do I? Maybe. Nah, what am I gonna have left? 7%? Yeah. I think that's it. Alright. So let's counterpoint, or let's switch between the records and the other stuff. All these freaking amendments and acts, Jesus. 44, 43, 42, 42. Alright, let's go with this one. Let's go with this one first. Yeah, alright, alright, alright. Oh dear god. Oh no, does this mean I have to remember a whole new set of confusing names? Wait, what? Is that, are there new people? Oh yeah, the new council, I guess. Ryu. The Mugunghwa High Council session for June 27th, 4042 has now begun. This is the first session since the meritocracy exams, and there's a lot of new faces here. Congratulations, counselors. Oh, so this is right after they return from the meritocracy exams. Okay. So this is like 3 months later or whatever. Yang, plus one very old face. It's mute. Mute. Counselor, boy, you're not going to go very far if you don't learn to respect your elders, like, now. No photo on file. Yang, just an observation. Ryu, moving on, there are a lot of items on the agenda that have been put forward by various counselors. Unless you'd rather spend your time bickering, I'd suggest we get started. Mute. Okay, let's get on with it. Ryu, first on the agenda is a tribute consolidation proposal from Counselor Smith. You can find the full text of it in Appendix 1. You have the floor, Counselor. Alright, before I continue, I'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. There's been probably like 3 hours, 2 to 3 hours between what you just saw a minute ago and now. Yeah, had some construction to help with at the home. But anyway, all is good. Let's get back into it. Of course, I have lost exactly where I was. So, I remember I was reading this thing about the new council. I think, yeah, I hadn't read any of these. Okay, I'm back on track. The Mugunghwa High Council session for June 27th, 4042, has now begun. And this is the first session since the meritocracy exams, and there's a lot of new faces here. Congratulations, counselors. That's from Ryu. Didn't she say, does that mean I have to learn a bunch of new names? I thought she said that. No, she didn't say it this time. Anyway, plus one very old face from Yang. Mute. Counselor, boy, you're not going to go very far if you don't learn to respect your elders, like now. Yang, just an observation. Wait a minute, have I read this before? Let's get on with it. No, I started reading it, but I never finished it. Okay. Yang, just an observation. Ryu. Moving on, there are a lot of items on the agenda that have been put forward by various counselors. Unless you'd rather spend your time bickering, I suggest we get started. Mute. Okay, let's get on with it. Ryu. First on the agenda is a tribute consolidation proposal from Counselor Smith. You can find the full text of it in Appendix 1. You have the floor, Counselor. Smith. Mute seems kinda what? Smith, thanks, sir. I'd like to propose moving a variety of small taxes and tributes and consolidate them into... Mute, no, absolutely not. Huh. She seems very... angry. Smith, if you just let me finish, I think you'll find it agreeable. Mute. You're proposing that the noble families save some money by dumping it on the peasantry. This is absolutely crazy. Wait, I thought engineering was supposed to be our family. Why is his name Han? I was just wondering who the hell that is, Counselor Han. No photo. You know, I read the proposal and it seems like this is shit that should be covered by them anyway. It's not like nobles have use for example, the inner deck rail system. What's your problem, Mute? Oh. What's your problem, Mute? I think she's gonna be pissed off in just a second here. Oh, I am also in favor. Mute. Good for you. My problem, Mr. Han, is that this is going to be a heavy burden on a peasantry that, as of this moment, actually doesn't hate us right now. Like, seriously, is that going to be the first action of the new High Council? Piss away all our goodwill? We're really okay with that? Yang. I think everyone but you is really okay with that, yes. Mute. I don't care. I'll security veto it if I have to, okay? She's really intense. Yes, she is. And it sounds like she's right. Yeah, I mean, how could that not just piss off all of the peasantry, as they call them? Smith. Can she do that? Ryu. If there's cause for it. Mute. There's all kinds of cause for it. It's tantamount to declaring war on the peasantry, which would be really stupid after all we've worked for, and it's also a security risk. We do that, it's going to lead to public demonstrations. Look, like, I appreciate what you're trying to do here, okay? I get it. I totally do. Sounds like she was stopping a lot of bad ideas, though. Yes, it does. Even though I don't like Mute at all, well, she's not all bad. I get it, I totally do. You're right, transferring it would be more fair, and I'm sure everyone here wants to save the extra silver. And you're new, so, like, I get it, but you need to understand. This is not how we do things here. The makeup of the council may have changed, boys, but it's still important that we're subtle in our actions. This is not subtle, okay? Yang. That's sanctimonious, Mute. That's the truth. Mute. Look, no vote is going to happen on this, okay? No matter what. Take the proposal back and find a way to do it that won't enrage the peasantry. Then we'll talk about it again. That's the bottom line. Smith. If that's the only way... Mute. It really is. Ryu. Then let's move on to the next order of business. Counselor Tay and Counselor O have a proposal that would... Mute. No. Ryu. Pardon me? Tai. Or Tay, I don't know. Will you not even let me speak? No photo. Was the replacement as Counselor of Culture? Ugh, he seems gross. Mute. Save your breath. It is a terrible idea. The effect will be a no... The effect will be no peasant will be able to use any of the ship's computers. You realize this, right? Tay. That isn't what it says. Mute. Oh, come on, you know that's going to be the effect, though. This is kind of insane. Oh. What's wrong with encouraging the peasantry to seek out a proper education? Mute. Because it's not going to encourage them to do that. It's going to encourage every single person who's ever written a letter with the word democracy in it to riot. Like, we're going to see things on fire, probably even outright banditry. Oh. It's important that we raise the level of literacy. As the meritocracy exam results demonstrated, it's a massive problem even in upper classes. Mute. Yeah, well, if you think it's going to have that effect, then you're even dumber than your predecessor. Yang. That's completely out of line. Mute. Yeah, withdrawn, but find another way to promote this agenda. One that won't end in my department needing to put out fires. Harsh. Yes, she is, but she is kicking ass here. For once, I can actually agree with what she's doing. And that is a rare thing indeed. Tay, will you abuse your security veto for everything this council puts forward? Mute, just watch me. Ryu, then there's no point in prolonging this. Next item on the agenda is a proposal tabled by Counselor Yang. The proposed Electoral Monitors Act. You can find the text of it in the fifth appendix. I hope you won't be vetoing this one out of hand. Counselor Mute. Mute. Well, I don't like the part where it takes money out of my budget for officers not under my control, but I don't think it's a security risk, no. Yang. For everyone else, the purpose of the act is to provide independent third-party monitors for the presidential elections to ensure they occur without the fear of tampering that's lingered in the past. I'm sure the Counselor of Security will attest to how much of a problem this can be. Mute. Yeah, it's a problem. No dispute there. Taking it out of my budget is kind of problematic, though. Ryu. Counselor Smith, can you think of any alternative funding sources the Act would be amended to use? Smith. No, in fact, I don't see any reason to put it to a debate. It looks like Counselor Mute will simply have to deal with it. I'm moving to call a vote immediately. Mute. Oh, I see how this is. Oh, seconded. Tay. I'd also like to second it. Yang. Same. Ryu. That was much quicker than I anticipated, Mute. Of all the petty... I guess the rest of the council is just as hostile as her, huh? Yeah. Yeah, it looks like everyone pretty much hates each other. Mute. Well, call it then, Ryu. How does the council vote? Yang? Favor? Cho? In favor? Han? Favor? Tay? In favor? Ryu? In favor? Oh, in favor? Smith? In favor? Mute. Okay, the Council of Security is in favor. Ryu. The act passes unanimously then and will be sent directly to the president for signing. It's traditional at this point to take a break for the morning at around this time. I motion to recess. Mute. Seconded. Gladly. Ryu. The council will reconvene in an hour then. Dismissed. Well, that made for riveting reading. Oh god, I can't wait to get past this stuff. Maybe I shouldn't have taken four of those and two others. Let's do something else. A grandmother knows best. Yeah, let's leapfrog back and forth to these freaking acts. Yeah. Alright, this is the oldest one. Kim So-yi. Grandmother knows best. Who is she? Who is she? Have I seen her before? Oh, yeah, her. Yeah. Really cool woman in the engineering department. She was married to Pyeon Naimun. She does seem pretty cool. Okay, cool. Room status? Relatively free of debris. No. Wait, isn't that what she said in the last log? Why is she always reporting on the room status? That's weird. Relatively free of debris, no laundry on floor, futon still unrolled, not really a point to doing it this late in the day. No dishes in room, that's just about good enough for me. Today was pretty exhausting at work. We're still doing cleanup from the fire on Monday and- wait a minute. Maybe this picture was taken from the fire or something. I mean, it looks like she's got like smudges on her face a little bit. I don't know. It'd be funny if the picture was actually done from, like, right after the fire happened or something? I mean, that wouldn't make any sense. It would be funny, though. Anyway. And I'm blown off on the ladder to get stuck in a room full of ash all day. It also meant in order to catch up on all my project work, I had to do 2 hours of overtime afterwards. It was not my idea of fun. Wait a minute. To get stuck in a room full of ash all day, that might actually be from where the picture was. I mean, it looks like she has a scarf. Maybe she was wearing that to keep the ash out of her lungs? I don't know. I can't figure out what the occasion is, but for some reason, when I got home from work, half the main branch of the family seemed to be in our living room. Even my grandfather. Former Counselor Kim, I don't think he got along well with Mute. He was the Counselor of Engineering. The Counselor of Engineering himself was there, shockingly. I wanted to just go lie down and hole up in my room, but given how rare an event that is, social obligations interfered. After thanking Grandfather for getting me that job once more, which he seemed nonplussed on the subject of, my grandmother instantly dominated the conversation by asking me if I'd found a man yet. Oh wait, this must be from quite a long time ago. Because she was with someone in the last log I read. Right, that's him. What about the grandmother? Kim So-yi's grandmother was married to the old Counselor of Engineering. Yep. Alright. My standard response, I'd love to, but work keeps getting in the way. She apparently didn't buy it. Stupid squeaky chair. My chair makes so much noise, I don't know if anyone can hear it, but... it just, like, squeaks anytime I move at all. And I just WD-40'd it. It doesn't matter. It doesn't make a difference. It is a piece of shit. Anyway. Why not? Isn't engineering a male-dominated field? She asked. It's not wrong, but nearly every single man is either named Kim or married to someone named Kim. I really like that she's an engineer. Me too. Or married to someone named Kim. And there's a few exceptions, like my boss, the gross one who forces me to clean up ashes instead of doing important work. I left that last part out in my answer to grandmother. It's not like I don't want to find someone. I'd sure like to move out from my parents' house and have someone for companionship. and eventually have kids when my career gives me the time for it. I'm not opposed to marriage, I really want it, but I don't think I'm brave enough to say the only reason why I've gotten to 22 years old without ever having a boyfriend is because I'm hopeless with men. In front of the entire main branch of the family. Yeah, that was exactly what I wanted to grow up to be like, too. She understands. She does actually sound a lot like what Hyun-ae was talking about, what she wanted to be. She wanted to be an engineer, or follow in her father's footsteps. Or even in front of anyone. I feel pretty embarrassed even writing this in my diary, where nobody but me is going to read it. Well, I'm sorry, but I'm kind of violating your privacy. It's okay, though. You're long dead, so you're not going to worry about it. Nope. So, I think I was supposed to be offended when she asked, "What if I found someone for you?" But actually, it seemed like a reasonable enough idea. She has good judgment, probably. And I don't believe in nonsense like love at first sight. The idea of getting together with someone through a matchmaker doesn't sound very hard to justify. Besides, if I don't like whoever she picks, I can always just say no. Able to say no, huh? Yeah, it looks like, well, I'll just keep reading it for now. So I asked, "Do you have someone in mind?" She seemed pretty taken aback by that. My parents, not so much. They didn't say anything. The bottom line is that it seems I now have a marriage interview with a Mr. Pyeon at some point next month. Apparently he is very sweet, dresses handsomely, and works as a cook for a living. Okay, yeah, that's the one she was, yeah, she ends up marrying. These all sound like good things to me, although I worry about what sort of man would resort to matchmaking. Well, I'm not one to talk. I was just thinking the same thing. Yeah, you're doing the same thing. I think it's good. Going to be fairly weird, but I'm looking forward to it. He looks like a nice guy. The old man Kim So-yi was going to have a marriage interview with. Wait, the old man? That he doesn't look old at all. He looks like late 20s, early 30s, maybe, at most? But I guess she has 22, right? Anyway. Yeah, she sounds really nice. So what was I gonna say? Oh yeah. I can always just say no. So I guess... I mean, obviously people had more choice about who they married back then, but you can see there's still some... like, almost arranged marriage sort of stuff. Like with, I always forget people's names. Chin-ah? Yeah, with Chin-ah. She was kind of being put into an arranged marriage. I mean, not super forcefully, it sounded like, but... it's kind of like something her family basically had to have her do, or really, really wanted her to do, for the good of the family, just for the money. So it didn't sound like quite arranged marriage or forced marriage, but it certainly was a high pressure, sort of, pressured into marriage sort of thing. But it looks like not everyone was like that. Like, she apparently can say no, and I guess her family wouldn't think that strange or disrespectful or something, so... that's good. Okay, and now we go back to the boring stuff. What should I go with? 43, 43, 42, well, I guess 42. Lineage Act Amendment, great. This is gonna make for exciting reading, folks. Come along with me. Get out your pillows. By the way, when I say that, I'm not criticizing the game. Like, I don't think it's poorly written or anything. I think this game is extremely well written. It's just that naturally reading about Lineage Act amendments and bureaucrat class acts and the Unity Act is just not nearly as exciting as reading about the people. But I know it's important information, because politics obviously, politics between the elite, the nobles, and the peasantry are obviously absolutely key, and I'm guessing are probably going to be the main, friction between those two groups is probably going to be what led to Year Zero, the reset, the big event, whatever the hell happened. So yeah, this is important stuff. It's just, well, it's politics, and frankly, politics to me are boring as shit. Anyway, Lineage Act Amendment. Oh yay, it's really long. Ryu, before I declare council back in session, I'll ask, have the counselors with differences on the One Lineage Amendment resolved them, or will this simply be a repeat of this morning? Mute. I'm okay. Oh. I think we've come to acceptable terms. Ryu. Then we can proceed. Council is now in session, and the floor is open. Smith. I'd like to modify my amendment to stipulate that all the provisions are optional, and the member of the family who receives the nobility stipend can be selected arbitrarily by the counselor. Han, what's the point of that? I was just thinking that. If it's all optional, why even make it? Oh. The point is that not every family is led by the eldest son. If we are to restrict the nobility stipend to a single branch of the family, it is important that it is not given to the wrong one, as we discussed this morning. Mute. Like, at length. I don't really get all this stuff about money. Neither do I, Hyun-ae. I don't know what the hell they're talking about. Han. So why not just give it directly to counselors, then? Ryu. As the counselor of security would say, more subtlety is required. It's better to make it about families than about individual men. Mute. That isn't something I'd say. Ryu. You still disapprove of the act, even with Counselor Smith's amendment? Mute. Well, I still think this one lineage nonsense is a stupid idea. I don't see any point in prioritizing elder sons in particular, even as a statement, and like alienating branch families have absolutely no logic to me. This is going to have all kinds of serious repercussions in the future. They're not going to be on my family, though. You want to hoist yourselves up on your own petards? That's okay to me. I definitely disapprove of the act, but in the capacity of the Counselor of Security, I won't object. Ooh, is this one of the seeds? Is this one of the seeds that led to the extremely patriarchal society we saw in the future? I don't see any point in prioritizing elder sons in particular, even as a statement, and like alienating branch families have absolutely no logic to me. It's going to have all kinds of serious repercussions in the future. Serious repercussions in the future. I think we're looking at one of the seeds that bloomed into the horrible problems we saw. Yeah. Smith, that will suffice then. Ryu, are there any counselors that do have objections or further items to propose? Cho, none that have a chance of carrying, no. Ryu, then Counselor Smith's item is added to the amendment, then, and the debate is closed. How does the council vote? Smith. In favor. Cho. Okay. Cho, the Counselor of Agriculture is against. Sorry, but I have to tell my family I tried. Yang. Also against, for the record. Whoa, okay. Serious opposition. Tay. In favor. Han. In favor. Oh. In favor. Ryu. In favor. Uh-oh. Mute. The Counselor of Security is against. Have fun explaining this one to your cousins, boys. It's not on me. Ryu. The amendment carries. 5 in favor. 3 against. Moving on. Yeah, not that many people are happy about that. Alright, let's go back to some... So, it's break time. Thank you, Hyun-ae, thank you. God. Please take me away from this politics. This political stuff, please. Hey, it's a good time to take a break, isn't it? I totally agree. Some of the things we've been reading have been really intense. Yes, they have. I don't really like some of the feelings they're bringing up in me. I understand. So let's take a break and talk about something else. Alright. Sounds good. What would you like to talk about? That is... Sorry, geez, this is awkward. I just don't really know what to say. Yeah, I have nothing. I'm sorry. I guess after all I was taught, I'm pretty lousy at filling a silence, aren't I? Well, I guess we should just get back to reading then. That's something I'm good at doing. Sorry, I know it's really awkward. It's fine, it's... Whoa, new message. Please deliver the AI, John Kim. Wait, what? I hope this letter finds you well. Thank you again for your work in recovering the Mugunghwa's records and at least partially solving the mystery of what caused the tragedy on board. We hope you find the agreed-upon payment to be acceptable. However, there's still an outstanding issue. We have reason to believe that your report was not entirely forthcoming, and that you were able to recover an AI identifying as Kim Hyun-ae from the ship as well. I'd like to personally remind you that the terms of the contract were to deliver all data recovered from the Mugunghwa, which would include all code associated with her too. Ha, yeah! John Kim, go fuck yourself! Seriously, just fuck yourself with your own dick. Nope. Nope. Don't worry, we have no interest in prosecuting her. Nobody in this galaxy has the authority to, regardless. Nor do we believe her to actually be the same entity as the woman responsible for committing genocide on the Mugunghwa. However, as the sole survivor of the ship and the carrier of Kim Hyun-ae's memories, she could provide invaluable information on the disaster that occurred, and it's important she testifies her experience to us. You don't have a vested interest in obscure UK SPA history. Hold on, let me try to remember what that stands for. Korean Space Patrol 8? No. Okay, I can't remember. It's like the United Korean Space something agency, something like that. You don't have a vested interest in obscure blah 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 history, but for the sake of all those people who died, it's important that we learn all that we can. Your employer has told me that you'll be in the solar system within a couple days. We'd be very happy to arrange a meeting with you and the Hyun-ae construct while you're in the region. There's something very disturbing about them calling Hyun-ae a construct. Very creepy. Thinking of her as a construct is creepy. Yeah. As this was part of the already paid for contract, I hope discussing this issue with your boss doesn't become necessary. It's just very important that we hear all there is to learn. Looking forward to hearing from you soon, John Kim, Saiju Colony Historical Society, Saiju Colony. Hold on, wait, do they just want to interview her, or do they want to take her? I mean, if they just want to interview her, then sure. If they want to take her, well, then they can shove their payment up their ass. Talk to my boss, I'll get a different job. I'll work at the nearest KFC. Space KFC. Is there KFC in space? I don't know, whatever. Anyway. So what exactly did they say? Deliver all data recovered, which would include all code associated with her, too. Yeah, if they want her data, no. If they just want to interview her, fine. If she wants to be interviewed, sure. Okay. Alright, we've got three more. Okay, I don't want to end, I don't want the last thing I read to be something, some boring political thing, so I'm going to read both of the political stuff, political things now, and then I'm going to end on a curious word from Kim So-yi. Alright, so this is the oldest one, Bureaucrat Class Act, which sounds, I don't even know what the hell that is. Okay. Wow, she's really even more hostile than before. Can she get more hostile than before? Okay. Let's find out what the hell's happened. Ryu. Let me just click on their pictures again. Okay, yeah, him. Let's get straight to the most important item of this session. The Bureaucrat Class Act. Mute. Otherwise known as the Cleaning Up the Mess That Everyone Should Have Seen Coming a Year Ago Act. Ryu. Counselor. Mute. Don't counselor me. Can we acknowledge, for the record, that this is an attempt at damage control for the idiotic One Lineage Amendment? Uh-oh. Well, I can see why she's so pissed then, if that's true. Yang, is this level of pettiness truly necessary? Han, I really think you're out of line, too. Mute. I'm glad you've offered your obligatory throwaway opinion for this session, Counselor Han. Han, what? Ryu, are we done with the derailment, Counselor Mute? Mute, no derailment from me. Clearly it's important to put this act through. I just want to start off by acknowledging, for the record, that this is a direct response to the problems caused by the One Lineage Amendment. That's all. Ryu. Fine. So noted. Now can we move on? Mute. Sure. Go ahead. Ryu. You have the floor, Counselor Smith. Smith. Contrary to what Counselor Mute says, this has nothing to do with the One Lineage Amendment. The purpose of the act is to weaken the lower class by dividing them. Wait, seriously, they're trying to fuck with the lower class even more? Jesus. They are playing with fire. Not to mention, it's totally morally disgusting. But just purely from a pragmatic standpoint, they're playing with fire. Mute. You mean the class that we've bolstered by alienating a new noble families with, like, every single session of council? Yang. Didn't you say you'd stop? Really hostile. Yes. I can see why she was going a bit crazy, though. With these kind of idiots around, I would go crazy, too. Yang, didn't you say you'd stop? Smith. I don't think I can be any more blunt. This isn't related to the One Lineage Amendment. The goal is to create a new social class with a higher standing than the peasantry without nearly as high a cost to us as noble families. There's about 10 appendices that outline the whole proposed arrangement. I still don't get any of this. What are they talking about? I have no clue. They want to make a new class? How do you make a new social class? Can you prescribe social classes? Can you just make them? Don't they just kind of arise? I don't know. Cho, is there room for debate on these numbers? Smith, heavens no. Ryu, as I understand, it's a very delicate budget. Smith, there's really no room for any amendment. Cho, understood. Yang, not everything needs to be a giant hostile debate, despite the Counselor of Security's penchant for it. Surely we can agree on Counselor Ryu's proposal without any further debate. Mute, okay. I'm not going to dignify that, but I'm pretty sure you meant Counselor Smith. Yang, yes, I misspoke, but thanks for the pendantry. Smith, then does anyone object? Wait a minute. I misspoke. What did he misspeak about? Surely we can agree on Counselor Ryu's proposal without any further debate. Oh yeah, it's Counselor Smith's. Was that a genuine misspeak, or did he let something slip? If he did let something slip, what? It's actually Ryu's proposal, not Smith? Even if that was true, I wouldn't know what to do with that information. Anyway, yes, I misspoke, but thanks for the pendantry. Smith, then does anyone object? Yang, I'll second a motion to vote if you need one. Mute. Nope, I don't object. Ryu, then with no objections, a vote will automatically be called. How does the council vote? Mute. In favor? Yang, that's a surprise. Mute, this is neither the time nor the place for your pettiness, okay? Just register your vote. Yang, you're one to talk, but of course, I'm in favor. Oh, likewise. Cho, in favor? Tay, in favor? Han, in favor? Ryu, in favor? Smith, in favor? Ryu, the act passes unanimously then and shall be sent directly to the president for signing. I don't really get any of this boring stuff at all. Neither do I. Mute. Since there isn't anything else important on the agenda, I move to dismiss council. Ryu, we're actually in agreement. The motion is seconded. Council will reconvene at a date to be determined next month. Dismissed. Thank God. Alright, let's read this last one, which I believe is the last one that exists. The last major political heavy thing from that block of M5, I think is where it came from. And then we can get to Kim So-yi. Unity Act. Wait, hold on. Wow, this atmosphere is... Hold on. Let me check the dates. Alright, so it's a bit after. Ryu, we all know what's on the agenda. I trust we can get through this in a civilized fashion. Smith, one hopes. Mute. I don't like your tone, Counselor. Smith, I didn't... Mute. Not you, the Counselor of Captaincy. Ryu, please don't derail this. Don't derail this, Counselor Mute. Your objections to the Unity Act have been thoroughly stated and noted. Your input is appreciated. Mute. Don't your input is appreciated me, okay? You're not going to shut me up. This is insane. This is, like, actually insane. I don't even know why it's being brought up again. Did you miss the memo? I'm security vetoing it. Holy shit, yeah, it seems like the council is getting even more fractured. It sounds like Mute was trying to keep things reined in somewhat. I mean, she's no shining angel of moral virtue or something, but she seems about the most sane one here at the moment. Ryu, it's not... Han, how the hell do you justify that? It has nothing to do with ship security. Mute. Are you kidding? Like, seriously? You honestly haven't considered the idea that removing all restrictions as to who can be president has, massively destabilizing consequences? Ryu. Really seems like she believes strongly about this. Yes, yes it does. Ryu, please read the record, Counselor. You'll find that an amendment has been added to address security's concern. The act very specifically says that it only removes all non-criminal, non-age-related restrictions. There aren't any destabilizing consequences. Mute. That doesn't address my concerns at all. I will not budge on this matter, okay? The security veto stands, and, like, I can't believe I actually have to argue why separation of powers is important. Tay, on what grounds do you even argue that the security veto would apply here? Mute, really? The possibilities for abuse are endless. It goes against every principle the current system of government was founded on. Tay, and that's a reason not to do something? Counselor Mute, you'd surely not suggest that those principles are unassailable. How will we ever improve our society if we defend bad ideas simply for the sake of conservatism? Mute. Okay, well, while you're off fantasizing about improving our society, it's my job to put my foot down on things that can jeopardize the ship's safety. Ryu, if the act is amended, would you even consider the possibility of rescinding your veto? Mute. No. Ryu, then please let the record be updated to include a signed document from President Park overriding the security veto. Not this time, Mute. Mute. Of course he did. That's cause for alarm in and of itself. Don't you see? He wants the ability to run for a second term. If we actually let him stay in the public spotlight for that long, that gets rid of our strongest control against democracy movements. Like, if you think that they were getting bad before, can you imagine what they'd be like after 10 years of a single, unified, charismatic leader with a government platform? 15? 20? Do you really think that would be okay? Okay, so it sounds like... it sounds like the president that they elected to be their puppet, to be purely the face of reform but not actually reform anything, it seems like he actually has more power and more control and more influence than they ever thought possible. Interesting. Yang. Wait, if she was worried about there being just one leader forever... Wait, what do you mean? I don't follow your thoughts, Hyun-ae. Yang. Except we've completely knocked the wind out of the movement's sails. Tay. Well, maybe he is thinking that. It's merely wishful thinking. Mute. Great. So, and now you're just offloading the problem onto me in the future. It's lost momentum now, but what about like a century from now? Our actions here have serious consequences. Tay. It doesn't look like you're convincing anyone. Note, a long pause follows. Mute. Okay. I'm willing to compromise. I know what I've lost. I'll support the act. Just give me an amendment that ensures a president can't have two terms, okay? Hell, even specify that it only applies to non-noble presidents. Just give me something here. Cho, I'd be willing to Ryu, I don't think that's necessary. Mute. You'll second the motion, Counselor Cho? Cho, sorry, strike my remark from the record. Whoa, she is getting steamrolled here. Or railroaded or whatever. Cho is going to support that. But Ryu shut him up. Or that is a he, right? As counselor, I don't know, I'm not sure. I think it was. So Cho is following Ryu. Cho is being whipped into place, basically. Cho is under Ryu's thumb, it looks like. And it looks like, since the president was going to go around Mute's security veto, that he's in on the whole thing. Maybe... are they trying to push Mute out? Are the other counselors trying to take society in a certain direction that Mute, they know Mute won't support, and they're trying to screw her and get her out of the game, basically? By making a deal with the president that if the president helps them get rid of Mute, the president will get another term? And that's why they're not supporting amending it so that people can't have two terms? Mute. What? How is it even controversial, Ryu? I don't see any reason for further debate on the matter. Whoa. Mute. Come on, there's no reason not to. All I want is to ensure someone like President Park doesn't run again. Will anyone second the amendment? Ryu, I'll move to vote on the act as it stands. Mute. Nobody? Tay, seconded. Mute? Oh, I see. Ryu, the motion passes. How does the council vote? Tay, in favor? Han, in favor? Smith, in favor? Yang, in favor? Ryu, in favor? Oh? Same? Wow, shot down. Yeah. I think they're colluding together with the president. Against Mute. Cho, in favor? Ryu? And the Counselor of Security? Against, one assumes. Mute. The Counselor of Security abstains. Note, this is the first abstention from a vote by Counselor Mute in the ship's history. Whoa. Ryu. Very well, the act passes. 7 in favor with 1 abstention, and that's everything on the agenda. We'll reconvene after the presidential election. Council is now dismissed. Okay, well, out of all the political things I've read so far, that was the most exciting. Yep. They had problems. So did he come back for a second term? We'll reconvene after the presidential election. They're about to have one. Alright, well. A curious word by Kim So-yi. The awesome engineer. So she got married. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. She just looks so cool, doesn't she? Those glasses and that hair and the lab coat, being in a lab. She's doing her status thing. Apartment status. Just moved in. Perfectly clean. Closet full of brand new cushions and linens. Cupboard full of spotless dishes. Bed is made. Husband's insistence. Husband. 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 What a curious word. I don't think I will ever get used to the idea. I mean, it's only been a day, but fiancé sounded just as curious to me too. And I don't feel like things are really any different. As stated, the wedding was today. Grandmother insisted on having a big formal affair of it. Certainly not in my interests, but my only condition was that I was to have no part in the planning. It seemed to make both her and Nae-mun happy. Who's that? Oh yeah. Wait a minute. What's his full name? Nae-mun. Okay. I begrudgingly dealt with the stuffy traditional clothing for her sake. After all, without her matchmaking, I never would have been married to begin with. Aw, that's really romantic, though. It was evidently in my best interests, though. After the ceremony concluded, I had another chance to converse with my grandfather. No picture. I don't think he got along well with Mute, who's the Counselor of Engineering. And after an entirely accidental slip of the tongue about my disgusting boss, drinking was a factor, I must confess, I am unused to how free it seems to make my tongue. I found myself with a promise of promotion to technical specialist. Ooh! Even for a wedding present, that was a tremendous gesture. I'm intensely looking forward to going back to work now. Finally, freedom from the embarrassment of cleaning ashes, and the ability to perform research. I will, of course, not be given my own assistance from the start, but it is still a huge step up. That's awesome! Technical specialist, that sounds awesome! Nice. So she got married to, I'm assuming, someone she actually likes, because she said she would say no if she didn't, so she just got married to someone she likes, and she just got a promotion. Nice. Sounds like she's doing really well. What else happened? Conversation with parents about moving out was emotional on their part, but largely unremarkable. They will cope. Still feel like this new home is too large for me, but it would be a lie to suggest that I don't love it. Having space for just the two of us, particularly free of awkward silence requirements in the bedroom, is as great as I'd hoped. Free of awkward silence requirements in the bedroom. Yeah, that'd be awkward. Oh, wait, what? Past that, busy day, but little else too worth noting. Naked husband is seemingly reading over my shoulder right now. Still doing it. Hasn't stopped yet. Yes, knock it off. Husband is now... This is great. Husband is now mocking very concept of post-coital diary writing. Seemingly, he does not want me to fall asleep. He does not want me to fall asleep with me showing any manner of affection to him. possibly even interested in sleeping on futon in another room, now expressing an unacceptably sincere level of apology. Still insufficient. You'll have to do better than that, husband. If you wa- Aw, oh, they sound like a cute couple. I'm happy for them. If you wa- File ends abruptly. That's adorable! Aw. Oh, I'm so glad I read that last rather than some stuffy political thing. Okay, that, I believe that's it. Yeah. Right? No unread? Show unread? Nope, that's it. And, sadly, I think we're out of power for the day, right? 7%? Wait, can I get more? Can I get more? I think I can get more. Okay. Sweet, I thought that was it. Wait, what's up? Oh. Hey, did you not see that one labeled The Death of Mute? I really think it's important that we read it. I actually did glance across that, yeah. I would agree that would be very important to read. I'm just going to make it so that one gets included in the extraction. I really want to read it. Good point. Alright, sounds good. So, can I get a full 6, or do I even have enough power for that? Can I? Alright, so there's the Death of Mute. I guess let's go back to 5, right? I think I'm done with M4. You know, I wonder if these pictures can be unlocked or something, like if they're a bonus? It really seems like something that Christine Love would do. I know there's a lot of bonuses under games and stuff. Little things you can find. Like this one I'm really curious about. Personal photos, 28 megabytes. That sounds like a lot of pictures. That or they just saved one picture and saved it as a TIFF. Which would be unfortunate for me. Should've went with PNG or JPEG. Well, actually, this, in the future, I'm sure those formats don't even exist anymore. I'm sure they've been superseded by something that's far better. Yeah, alright, so yeah, M5. Let's go with M5. Kim So-yee. A lot of here from Kim So-yee. I'm really curious what updated wrinkled face textures is. You know what? That's gotta be from Mute, right? Updating her age as she ages, updated wrinkled face textures. That's gotta be from Mute. Keepsake from Earth. Video. Huh. Whoa. Fired. This one is from Kim So-yee and it says fired. Wait, why can't I grab that? Oh shit, I don't have the power. Fired, what? Oh no. I thought maybe somebody was going to have a good ending, but it looks like even Kim So-yee isn't going to. Uh-oh. Well, I don't want to... That sounds like the end of her story. So let's grab something else before that, yeah. Well, let me just go back to pay cuts. Maybe that's leading up to the firing. Pay cut, Alright. Anything else here that's, like, blows out at me? Like the Mute, Death of Mute, Election Night, Speech. Nothing really stands out except for Fired, but I don't want to read that yet before I've read the backstory to what led up to it. So, alright, let's go. Death of Mute. Research problem. Pay cut. Okay, yeah, The Death of Mute is the earliest, or the most recent one, and also probably the most important, so I'm going to save that for last. Kim So-yee, December, alright, let's go with the oldest one from Kim So-yee, The Research Problem. Oh, that's good for her. Apartment status, no time to make the bed this morning, otherwise spotless. Dishes need to be washed. Mr. Han finally responded to my message. That's the first time I've seen his picture. Wait, is that the person from the counselor meetings? This is the first time... Wait, no, it can't be. This is the first time we've read about this person. No, it can't be. Well, holy crap, he looks like a freaking rock star. Seriously, he looks badass. Damn. Okay. Now I'm gonna stop basking in my envy of his coolness. Mr. Han finally responded to my message. I'd been so excited to have him assigned to me as a research assistant. Oh, she finally got a research assistant! Certainly the help was well deserved after my recent overburdened workload. Or at least in my estimation. I've considered the possibility the research chief's intentions were not good in doing so. What do you mean? It seems unlikely, however. Despite his remarks on the perilousness of my position, it seems as though he is earnestly grateful for my work, and we didn't assign... And he didn't assign Han to me until I specifically outlined the preliminary research proposal into the radiation problem. Okay, so that's... the radiation problem is what she was researching when she... got a blood sample from Hyun-ae. So I must have believed that he truly did think the research was worth pursuing, and that I would require assistance for it and nothing more. I certainly was optimistic for the first week. I worked with Han. He seemed receptive to my proposal, and having overviewed some of his prior work, he seemed competent enough. During one of our lunch meetings, I told him that I'd be interested in discussing his graduate thesis on processor distribution with him, and it sounded fascinating. In retrospect, perhaps I should have noticed something in his body language. It did strike me as noteworthy that he touched my hands more than one might expect while making gestures to illustrate his points. But I didn't think too much of it at the time. I don't know, I'd really like it if someone touched me like that. She was married at this point, right? Yeah, she had to be. Yesterday evening, at his suggestion, I invited him to our apartment to discuss the proposal in depth. It seemed reasonable enough, or more accurately, I wanted to show off how nice our new apartment is. I haven't had any prior opportunity to do so. Because of that, I went along with his suggestion. After getting tea, I sat down on the couch to show him the proposal document I'd written up. I had to be next to him or he wouldn't be able to see it. After a brief discussion of the general thesis, particularly as to the difficulty in discovering what safe levels of gamma radiation should be when in a closed environment as the Mugunghwa is, I decided to tell him the more radical part of my theory. Well, really? I mean, I remember that was a really big problem in my time. Wait, what was? I guess we're about to find out. Now that there's no risk of a co-worker overhearing, I have a confession to make, I said to him. Oh god, he's gotta be totally getting the wrong impression at this point. Now that there's no risk of a co-worker overhearing, I have a confession to make? And he's back at her place, and they're sitting next to each other? This is about to get really awkward, I know it. Uh-oh. I said to him. He seemed receptive. I actually wish to investigate a secondary theory in the bounds of this new project. I hypothesize that not only does ambient radiation have a deleterious effect on fertility, but that ambient radiation is outside of safe levels and therefore has been a contributing factor to the Mugunghwa's declining birth rates. Perhaps the major one, I admitted. It was certainly not something I wanted to present to the research chief without being able to provide a connection, but I unreasonably assumed I could trust Han with it. Uh-oh. Oh no. Well, maybe we could explore that theory together, he said in an uncomfortable manner and put his hand on my leg. Okay, this is where it gets uncomfortable. It felt like he was not taking me seriously, and I protested to that effect. I'm serious. This may be premature, but I would like to eventually attempt to apply this research to investigate the birth rate problem, I said. That's dependent on our work in first proving this initial proposal, of course. I can't remember how he responded, but he moved his hands further up my leg. It was inappropriate and felt uncomfortable. Holy shit, this guy sounds like a creep. I mean, she's given him plenty of signs, not even signs, just like outright said that that's not what she's going for, and she's not into it. Oh, jeez, So Yi. I can't remember how he please stop that, I told him. He didn't. Unable to think of what to do, I continued talking and hoped he would focus on that instead. Oh my god, that is awkward. This is the preliminary proposal I showed the chief, I told him, showing him the document. I paged through it until I found the right portion. As you can see, the highlighted section is some necessary background detail. Since you are available as an assistant now, I'd like you to... Diary writing is supposed to be cathartic, but I'm finding this difficult to write about. Maybe tea will help. Whoa! At that point, I was cut off mid-sentence by the insertion of his hand into my underwear. This was far beyond the point of uncomfortable. Gee, that's just downright sexual assault. This is horrible. I can't believe I said... That's really horrible. I'd like you to, I started, but was interrupted by another movement. It was at this time that I realized he would not stop on his own. I had no idea what to say. It did not seem likely to me that I could think of anything to make him stop. Please stop, I said anyway. He didn't. And when I said that, I saw that he was staring at me. I was not able to decipher the expression, not an unusual occurrence with me, but it scared me and I looked away on reflex. I tried to figure out what I had done to elicit this. I'm not great with most social interactions, and I considered the possibility that I had somehow signaled that this was what I wanted. Maybe it was the invitation home that triggered it. Maybe. I could not figure out what I had done wrong at the time, and I am still struggling. No, it's not her fault. Why does she think that? Yeah, she's blaming herself. I cannot figure out what I had done wrong at the time. She hasn't done anything wrong. He's done something wrong. Finally, after enduring it for far too long, I decided I would try to pull myself away. Then I ran, out of the room, out of my own home, into the corridor. Even at the time, it occurred to me to be thankful that he let me run. Wait, thankful that he let me run? He could have easily overpowered me. Ever since I first had that thought, I'm having a hard time not imagining what that would be like, and it induces a sense of nausea. I would go so far as to characterize the thought as horrifying. I would like to stop thinking about it. Jesus, what? I hid at the office for 2 hours, pretending to be doing overtime. Nobody questioned it anyway. The thought occurred to me that I could have simply hidden in another room of my home. The bedroom and washroom doors both lock out, but it was too late then. From the office, I wrote him a message, telling him that it would be in both our best interests if we mentioned the incident to nobody. And I told the research chief that his help was unnecessary. It took many rephrasings until I had something I was satisfied with to send Han. I ended up phrasing it as a threat. I could only hope it would be taken seriously. Realistically, I could have probably waited a shorter period than 2 hours to return. But I wanted to be certain he'd be gone when I got back. Thankfully, he was. Instead, Naemun was there to greet me. Are you okay, sweetheart? He asked immediately after welcoming me home. I do not know how he could tell something was wrong. I said nothing. I couldn't tell him about it. There was no way. I'm unworried about him judging me or blaming me, but regardless, I do not think he would understand. Probably he would want to cause a commotion over it, file a complaint or some equally troublesome gesture. You really look upset. Do you want to talk about it? He asked. God, Naemun sounds like such a good person. He'd probably want to cause a commotion over it, file a complaint or some equally troublesome gesture. God, she... Instead of... She'd rather just blow over the whole thing rather than... get the douchebag creep in trouble like he should be. Why? She seems to be kind of blaming herself. Is she ashamed? That's horrible. I shook my head. Okay, of course. That's fine. Give you a hug, at least, he offered. Aww. I nodded, and he hugged me. I had only nodded reluctantly, I had thought. I really did not want anyone to touch me after the whole incident. The idea of a man touching me just made me uncomfortable to think of. Yet when he put his arms around me, despite that thought, I ended up gripping him very, very tightly. He's such a good man. I'm really glad she had him. Me too. Very, very tightly, and held on for far longer than is considered normal. I realized it wasn't the same thing at all. My reluctance was unfounded. Being held like that could not have been any more different. I'm not really certain as to how to describe it, so all I can say is that it made me feel safe. I felt a sense of longing to just stay like that forever. I'll make dinner for you, sweetie, he offered. How about soft tofu stew, extra spicy, just for you? That'll make you feel better. I doubted that any food would have the power, but offering to make my favorite for me was a very sweet gesture. I'm glad he's here. Thanks, I said. Just sit back and relax, okay? I'll have some tea for you in a moment, he told me. God, wouldn't it be so nice to have someone who could cook and bake? That would be awesome. As it turned out, dinner was lovely and did raise my mood. The thought of Han touching me kept coming back to me, as I suspected will for a long time, but then being able to look at my caring husband comes as a source of great comfort. After dinner, Mr. Han finally responded to my message. Uh-oh. He was threatening in tone in his response, and implied that I made the first move with him, and that he could use that as blackmail material with my husband if he so wished, but ultimately agreed to the terms I laid out. I sent a short, one-word response. Okay. The suggestions he made were frustrating, and it makes me wish I could respond harshly to him, tell him how wrong and bad he's being. But engaging with him more won't make anything better. I just want to forget about the whole thing. Fighting would be counterproductive to that goal. Not to mention massively wasting of time when I'm already overburdened at work. So I sent that message and instead put down all my feelings here, where nobody else will see. Jeez, that's such a scary situation. I wouldn't have been able to deal with that. And now I will wash the dishes with Naemun, because I'm tired of dwelling on this. It's interesting the way she is dealing with it. She's burying it. Is that a good thing? I couldn't say. I don't think it is. Usually burying things just makes things worse, but I couldn't say. Either way, I'm just filled with horror at what she had to go through, but also, I'm really glad she's with Naemun, because he's an awesome guy. Alright, pay cut. This is a while after. Okay, Dad, I don't think it's gonna end well. Things obviously went wrong. Anyway, I'll be right back before I continue. Okay, I have returned. Let's read Pay Cut by Kim So-yi. Let's see where this is going. Sounds like hard work, so that's what it's like to be an adult? Unfortunately, yes. Apartment status, no time to make the bed this morning, all dishes washed, drying rack full. Floors probably need to be swept at some point this week. I'll do it when I'm less annoyed. In the past month, in addition to the research work that is in my actual job description, I've organized 3 successful maintenance projects, compiled over a dozen sets of... minutes? Wait, compiled over a dozen sets of minutes? What's a set of minutes? I don't know what that means, and learn a recently resigned secretary's filing system in order to explain to a coworker. To say nothing of the many smaller contributions I've been asked to make, all of which unrelated to my research. This is the hardest I've worked in my life, and I am proud of what I have done. Yeah, she sounds extremely skilled. Wow. Despite this, today I had to take a pay cut. Seriously? Jesus. It sounds like she's doing 2 people's freaking jobs and she's getting a pay cut? She should be getting a raise or a better position. When I was called into the research chief's office, I expected the opposite. A commendation for exemplary work would have been warranted. Some manner of praise, given the current economic circumstances, a promotion would have been unlikely. Regardless of the fact that it is very much due. Instead, my hourly pay will be reduced by 10%, effective immediately. That is such bullshit. That doesn't sound fair. No, it is not. I'm sorry, it's nothing personal, he told me, just between you and me. I've been really impressed by your work. I appreciate it all. I'm afraid it's just a matter of department-wide policy. We've been asked to cut costs on all high-risk employees and put them towards training costs.
Whoa, what?
Cut costs on all high-risk employees and put them towards training costs. What's a high-risk employee? Exactly what does that mean? I'm sure you understand. No, I said, I do not understand. Elaborate. In what manner am I high risk? It means at risk of quitting. I mean, really. It's because you've got more options now. We have to compensate for that somehow. Lately, because of the whole motherhood credit thing, we've been losing a lot of highly qualified women. I mean, I'm sure you understand, he said. I didn't. If you decide to quit and have children, it's going to be expensive to train a replacement. Especially one as qualified as you. Well, that's a backhanded compliment if I've ever heard one. I guess even at a time when women were allowed to work, things were complicated. Yep. I have no intention of having children at 24, I told him, or at any other point in the foreseeable future. The concern is unwarranted. Well, statistically speaking, as a married woman, you are. Personally, I believe you. Because I know you well. I'm sure you're not lying, but I can't make an exception for anyone who says that. If I did, anyone could say that, and we'd still have a huge problem. I was unable to think of anything appropriate to say. I found the suggestion upsetting. Yeah. I mean, you can see the logic in that, right? I can show you the actuarial reports if you'd like, he offered. What a load of bullshit. Please do that, I said. After I returned home from work, I had a chance to review them, and unsurprisingly, they are consistent with what he had said. I could find no grounds under which to criticize their numbers. It seemed to be based on solid research. But if you think it all checks out, you'll understand that it's fair, right? That's just how it goes, statistically speaking, he said. I can't argue with the logic, I finally admitted. I hoped that when I got home, the reports would be problematic and I could criticize them. I knew you'd be rational about it, he told me. That's why I'm glad you're still with us. You're definitely a logic-minded person. You understand how statistics work, and really, given how hard you work, I wouldn't be surprised if this wasn't just a temporary loss. You're well on the way for a promotion. Yeah, no kidding. I guess sometimes even the past sucked, too. I was uncertain as to how to argue with that, too. I was intended to take it as a compliment, and so it seemed like the only thing to do. He was right, of course. I can see the logic, and I am unable to argue with it. Seeing the logic has yet to have any mitigating effect on my annoyance at the matter. However. Yeah. I see the logic, but it's still bullshit. Okay. Hey, it's ready. Wait, it's... What's ready? What are you talking about, Hyun-ae? Well, I don't know if you noticed, but the decryption is ready. What? The decryption of what? Did I just totally forget something, or what? I'm really nervous to find out. What? Oh, it was decrypting? I thought it was just done. Okay. But finally, we can read about what happened to Mute. Yep. Here we go. The Death of Mute. 4045. Which, actually, hold on, let me check everything else. Is that the oldest thing I have? Where is it? There's Death of Mute. 4545. Is this sorted by year? I think this is sorted... No, it's not sorted by year. 44, 44, 44, 45. It might be the oldest thing I have. Hold on, February and 40. Well, it's one of the oldest things I have, certainly. Alright, the Death of Mute. Oh no, so that's what this all was? A message? Wait, what do you mean? What did you think it was? That is some weird music that just started up. What am I about to read? Okay, I'm really curious now. Let's get into this. Looks very long. Even Mute could be scared? Oh, I shouldn't have scrolled down. Okay. Dear Mute, if you're reading this, it means that the version of us that wrote it is dead. Wait, what? If you're reading this, it means that the version of us that wrote it is dead. Let me read that a third time. Mute. If you're reading this, it means that the version of us that wrote it is dead. Okay. I'm gonna have a hard time absorbing that. Let's continue. I don't know what sort of world you woke up in, and I don't know what sort of person you are, but you're me, so I bet you're okay. I'm about to have my memory wiped. So I'm leaving as much information about what happened embedded in my code as I can, where it won't get erased. I hope you're able to make sense of it all. I'm about to have my memory wiped. Is this at the same time the restart happened? The everything resetting back to zero? Please forgive me for failing you. You've been thrown into a world I'm sure you don't understand. I want you to know who you can and can't trust. I want you to be able to put things right. You're probably going to feel overwhelmed by all this information, but that's okay, Mute. It's okay to be scared. Even with 1600 years of experience under my belt, I'm so scared right now too. Even Mute could be scared. Yeah, I didn't even know Mute was possible of being scared. You know, I wasn't at all suspicious when, just weeks before we were to enact our coup, Ryu prorogued the council for half a year. What does prorogued mean? Like, I thought it was ballsy. I thought it was a sign of his increasing totalitarianism. Let me try that word again. Totalitarianism. Totalitarianism. But nothing more than that. We just modified our plan to take him into custody in his home instead, which we had more than enough numbers to handle, and went on ahead. The first stage, getting trusted security officers at every critical position on the ship, then disabling the rail system and all outside doors, went okay, without any problems. Holy crap, this is really long. Alright, so we're gonna learn a lot of stuff here about what happened. I followed along Hyo So-young, was that again? Oh yeah, yeah. Mute's closest lieutenant, yep. Who seemed to love Mute. Yeah, I think she's in love with Mute. I followed along Hyo So-young and a team of 30 officers to personally take Ryu under arrest at his home. When we got the all-okay signal from every team, So-young gave the order to go ahead, and simultaneously, every door in every counselor's home flew open. Her team burst in through the open front gate, into his home, guns at ready. The house staff all froze up, and while her team secured the first room, So-young went for the nearest maid she could find and grabbed her by the collar. "Where's Counselor Ryu?" she barked. The maid quietly whimpered directions. Then, with two of her officers remaining to lock down the door, she ordered the rest into action. That must have been scary for the maid, though. Yeah, that would be terrifying. Before we managed to reach him, we ran across Hyun-ae. Wait, who's that? I think I've seen her a couple times or once. The president of Mugunghwa University, that's right. Okay. What is Hyun-ae saying here? I don't know about her. She seems, well... Well, what? Before we managed to reach him, we ran across Hyun-ae, guarded by a single pair of men in electoral monitor uniforms with their weapons holstered. Whoa, what? I felt good. We had them vastly outnumbered, with enough of our own officers to completely lock down everything and still hold them at gunpoint. Elsewhere on the ship, reports from the other team started coming in of successfully arresting the other counselors. Okay, there... I'm thinking there was collusion between the counselors to do bad stuff, and that's what she was doing. That's what Mute was doing. She was getting all of the counselors at the same time. Successfully arresting the other counselors, so they're doing it all... They're striking at one moment. "Please, resist arrest," So-young said, harshness in her voice. "I'd love to strike you down where you stand here and now, you murderous bitch. So come on, resist arrest." And that was the first time that evening that I truly worried. Hyun-ae didn't seem scared at all. Rather, she smiled at us. Uh-oh. "No, we shall surrender peacefully," she said in a far too relaxed tone, while her men raised their hands. "No excuses for unseemly violence, I'm afraid." "Cuff them," So-young angrily ordered her own officers, who quickly did. Then, like out of nowhere, the man we were looking for appeared at the end of the hallway. "How very bold of you, Mute," said Ryu. "Well, this should be pretty familiar, President Ryu," I said, emphasizing the title. "President Ryu. This could have gone differently, you know, like if you'd only been less power-hungry." Okay, so he became the new president. Me, power hungry, you laughed. When I came into power, this whole retrograde society was power hungry. I never asked for this position, woman. It was thrust on me. You walked towards us. Stop there or I'll shoot you, Seo Young snapped at him. No, you won't, Hyun-ae said as he continued to come closer. I don't think a weak person like you has the guts to do it. Awkwardly hover around his conversation at a party while dressed up in men's clothing, perhaps. But you'd never shoot him. It pains me to say this, but don't shoot, I said only into Seo Young's ear. A successful coup doesn't fire any shots. He's arrogant, but harmless. Quiet, dear, he said. Wait, is that quite or quiet? I've forgotten the difference. I don't remember how to spell one or the other. Anyway, this really feels like, it feels like it's really off. Yes, yes, it obviously is. Something's about to go very wrong. But it's true. You'd lose your precious moral high ground, and I know you wouldn't want that. Lieutenant, please, I said, just do the honor of putting handcuffs on this criminal already. She briskly walked over to him, and he just crossed his arms, arrogantly staring down at her. No, you won't do that either. In fact, release my fiancé right now, he said. Then without any further warning, Seo Young decked him. Good. He stared at her, shaking his head. That's enough of that, he said. Sorry, I must have misjudged the timing of this. It should only take a few more seconds. Wait, what? What's about to happen? Then suddenly, while we were all perplexed by what he meant by that, there was a huge noise and the entire ship shook violently. Within a few seconds, I'd received a report, an explosion starting in the middle of the plaza. Whoa, what? An explosion? What are they playing at? Explosion on the plaza? Wow, that's really serious. Yes, it is. They planned to have an explosion in the plaza? Why? Seems like your little rebellion is awfully dangerous, he says. Looks like it'll justify some pretty drastic measures to put you down. Oh, shit. He's gonna make it seem like the rebellion was hurting people and blowing things up and violent, and that they had to do extreme things to quell it. Wow. Son of a bitch. Smart son of a bitch. Seo Young suddenly put her knife to his chin. What the hell was that? I demanded, increasingly worried that things were not going to plan. The first of two, he said. The second should go off in about 10 minutes, unless I can personally enter the disarm code into the computer. Wow. You're out of control, I snapped at him. Like, do you really think you can threaten your way out of this? Yes, he said, confidently, because the second one is located inside the ship's computer core. You're bluffing, Seo Young growled. I'm honestly not, he said. Counselor, remember that routine computer core maintenance on March 3rd? Send in your men to check, if you don't believe me. Come on, easy enough to confirm. It's huge, you can't miss it. Wow. I didn't like the idea of being ordered by him, but if he was telling the truth, that'd be catastrophic. And like, someone with his power could very easily have sent a bomb in there behind my back, far before I even thought to suspect him of anything. If he had the foresight. And thinking about how long-term his takeover of the government had been, foresight was one thing he had. I ordered the nearest officer to investigate. You'd have to be mad to do that, I said. You'd destroy everything if you took out the ship's computer. Oh please, don't be dramatic. It's not that powerful, and it's bolted directly to your core. Sure, there will be collateral damage, but we could probably do with a clean start anyway. We'll get by, he said. Sorry, I'll get by. You'll be dead. Wait a minute. Hold on. Clean start. We could probably do with a clean start anyway. Was that what led up to year zero? Was that the clean start? That won't get you out of it, Seo Young said, pushing her blade closer against him. If you do that, I'll just shoot you where you stand. Just then, the report from the officers sent to check on the computer core arrived. Sure enough, there was an unidentifiable device strapped to the core. Can you disarm it within 10 minutes, or relocate it? I asked them, starting to panic. I'm sorry, ma'am, we can't even reach it, said the officer into his earpiece. It's at least 10 meters up, and the maintenance ladder's been removed. There might be one on the engineering deck, but you'd never make it in 10 minutes. Okay, you should... I had to stop and think. You should get a safe distance away, then wait on further instructions. Mute out. Back in Ryu's home, I turned to look at him. He smirked. "Found it yet?" he asked. I tried to think of what to say to reassert control. My processors went to full, trying to come up with something and failing. "I'm sorry, Lieutenant. He's telling the truth," I said. I know exactly how she must have been feeling. Oh no, Mute. Good. Now that we have that sorted out, put down your weapons, please, and surrender the root password. Hurry, ladies, you have only 10 minutes, you know. He mocked us. If that bomb goes off, I will absolutely slice your neck open, Seo-young snapped, unfazed. That's a promise. Your fiancé will watch you die gruesomely. My mind continued to race, drawing on all available processing power, desperately trying to come up with a way to get out of this. Seo-young's threats would never work. He knew I'd have to capitulate if I was to survive. I'd used up 4 whole minutes of the time allotted, and I had nothing. I started to truly become scared as I realized that there were only 2 options, stand firm and risk dying, or give up everything. I couldn't risk dying. "Lieutenant," I said, the confidence drained from my voice. "Do what he says." "That's what I thought," he said. "What?" Seo-young was rightfully shocked. "You can't be serious." "It's over, Lieutenant," I said quietly. "We've lost." Then, into everyone's earpiece. "All units, we failed. Please surrender peacefully and await further instructions. Please, again, please surrender peacefully and await further instructions. Mute out." "Ma'am, we outnumbered them massively. We've gotten them beaten. We can't just give up now," she shouted. "I can't risk dying, Lieutenant," I said. "Really? Whatever happened to being willing to stake everything on this? You'd rather let So-hai grow up in a ship run by this piece of scum." Wait, who's that? Who is that? I don't know who that is. I've forgotten. Is that the first time she's been mentioned? Well, anyway, obviously she's... did she have a daughter? Not Mute, I mean... Anyway. "Grow up in a ship run by this piece of scum, then put your own life on the line," she shouted, horrified. I was horrified. 2 options, betray her or risk my own life. I wished with every bite of my being that I could have picked the second option. But I knew I couldn't. I knew, as my very core directive, that safety was more important than freedom. 1600 years of experience told me that. I can't die. Without me, who'll keep the ship safe? I pleaded. Sorry to interrupt, but you're running out of time fast, Ryu cut in. I would have given my life for you, she cried at me. You wouldn't do the same? I'm so sorry, I said softly. In 100 years, nobody will remember this day, either way. But they'll still need me here, still need me there to keep the ship safe. God, that's such a horrible situation. She's right. That's the horrible thing, she's right, but at the same time... At the same time, she's betraying someone she, I'm pretty sure, loves, or at least is very close with. And she would do the same, but she won't give up her life. That's gotta hurt a lot. You'd be willing to give your life to someone? Give your life up for someone, but they wouldn't? Man. I can't believe, she trailed off. I won't do it. I won't accept that. I let out a long sigh. I could think of one thing to say to convince her to stand down, but it felt like too harsh a betrayal, too cruel of a manipulation, and just to save my life. I said it anyway. Seo-young, please, if you love me, then do this for me, I begged. She stared at me in horror, and I felt overwhelmed with guilt as she lowered her knife. I knew what her expression was saying without her using any words. She couldn't believe I'd done that. Neither could I. Right, the rest of you, please put your guns on the floor, Ryu ordered. Do what he says, Seo-young said quietly. I couldn't look any of them in the eye as they all followed her order. You can come in now, he called out behind him, and on cue a small unit of his electoral monitors rushed in. Uncuff these 2 men and then take the rest away. Said Hyun-ae quietly, the first she'd spoken since the initial confrontation. Mine too? I don't know, powerless is a good look for you, he said, smirking at her. Let's get to those later. She shrugged. If you say so. Whoa, kinky? I don't even know what the hell to make of that. I watched in sad horror as my off... So the reason the ship was the way it was in my time was because... I watched in sad horror as my officers were all escorted out of the hallway, Seo Young looking back only briefly at me with an agonized expression on her face. Then they were gone, and I couldn't bear to shift my focus to another camera to follow. Now, let's have the root password, counselor, he said. With tortured reluctance, I displayed all 200 characters of it on screen for him. 200 characters, damn! Wow. It's all yours, I said quietly. Now turn off the bomb. Let's change to something easier to remember first, he said, and typed away at the screen. Then I got a notification. The password had been changed, and I no longer had any access to it. Now turn off the bomb, I insisted desperately. Bomb? Oh, please. I'll have to have your men trained to be more thorough, he said. It's just a noisemaker. I'd never be that reckless. But Hyo-So Young's rebellion setting off a bomb in the computer core would sure be a pretty drastic and unsympathetic, wouldn't it? Oh, Jesus. What? I cried, and at that point I lost all will to resist. No action I had taken today had turned out to be anything but disastrous. The only logical conclusion was I should stop. But the idea of Seo Young taking all the fall pained me. Then I guess it's all over now, was all I could say. I'll go along with your agenda from here on out. Good, he said. And then it felt like it was finally over, and like I could simply go on with my life, in a persistent state of deep shame at having betrayed my lieutenant, out of terror for my life. Then Hyun-ae cut in and ruined that. Could you explain something to me, love? He grinned at her and stroked her cheek. Of course, dear. What? So that's how she was. That's so cruel. Wait. Let's figure out what she means. Well, it's just... How do you plan on ensuring her loyalty? I think I'm just missing something, that's all. She trailed off in an obnoxiously soft voice. I had lost all will or ability to say anything. What was the point? I was incapable of doing anything right today. Old, useless, and cowardly. That's me. I have the root password, of course. I can shut her down at any time. Ah, so you intend more threats, then, she said. I get it. I don't expect any more trouble from her. Right, certainly, she said. Although, you know, that thing you said about having a fresh start for our new dynasty did sound awfully romantic. If only we could all just forget about the old society that produced women like Mute and her lieutenant and start all over. And that was when I realized there was no way I was getting out of this alive. Shit. If only we could all just forget about the old society that produced women like Mute and her lieutenant and start all over. And she was the one suggesting it. It was a woman suggesting that. Why? Romantic, huh? He said, thoughtfully. Hyo-So Young's attack on the computer core was supposed to render it so damaged it couldn't function, so far as the peasantry is concerned. After all, we'll make it so it destroyed all the data too. Total system wipe. Start year zero of our new dynasty right from zero. I'll just figure out how to do that. Year zero. So that is fucking year zero. That son of a bitch. I stared in horror. All that, it had been for nothing. To think that I had abandoned my poor lieutenant and my entire cause just to die anyway. To think I had started the day from a position of some power. A position where I still could have, like, done something. Then thrown it all away for nothing. To think I'd be unable to fulfill my duty of keeping the ship safe. I didn't like her, but reading about her broken like this is... I agree, I didn't like her either, but this is horrible. Don't do that, I pleaded. Please. Haven't you learned yet? Don't tell me what to do, Mute, he said. Don't make me beg. How pathetic, Hyun-ae scoffed at me. That was it. Because of her, I was doomed. and then I figured out the only thing I could do to salvage things. If I could make it so he felt content to just delete my memories instead of my entire program, I could encode a message to you in my base code, so the first time you ran a self-diagnostic, you'd know. And they would still think you were docile and had no memory. Ah. It was the best I could do, Mute. I knew it'd be rough on you, and I'm sorry. No, like, I said reluctantly. Do a restart to initial settings operation instead. It'll wipe all data, all memories, all clocks, but you'll still be able to use the computer. And you'll still live, he said. Remembering nothing, I said quietly. Ask Counselor Han if you don't believe me. So that's how it happened. Yep. Well, thank you, he said, smiling cruelly at me. I'm glad you're able to be useful to me to the end, Counselor Mute. I don't know what you'll be able to do. Maybe it's too late to get rid of what Ryu has put into motion. Maybe there's nothing you can do about that. The password's being entered right now to commence the system reset, so I have to stop now and save this all to my code. Goodbye, Mute. If you can, please tell Xiao Young I'm so sorry, and please, keep the Mugunghwa safe. You can do it. I believe in you. Mute, I didn't know. Neither did I. Again, I didn't like her and I still don't, but Jesus. Wow. Mr. Investigator, Mr. Investigator. Yes, Miss Investigator. So, I guess... Jeez, poor Mute. That is exactly what I was thinking. I suppose... Remember, back when I was on the Mugunghwa, and I said that what happened in the Year Zero was a big giant mystery, even to me? Well, I guess we solved the mystery. I guess we did. I don't know what to think. And I don't know how to feel about Mute. The old one seems like a good person, but in the end... Well, I don't know. I just don't know. It's all so complicated to me. I guess I just feel like... It should have been something more. All my suffering, the horrible world I woke up in, that's the explanation for it? I lost everything and lived in misery because of that? Above all else, I never imagined when I tried to think of what it could have been that made everyone become all stupid and traditional. That made them abandon all the values that I grew up on. That made my adopted family treat me like a prize to be married off and nothing more. I never once imagined that it was a woman who suggested the whole thing. I know, I was thinking that, like, what the fuck? How horribly ironic and sick is that? Mute, I feel so conflicted about... But... Oh, Hyun-ae? Wait, what? That was a weird sentence. I read about her. After all, she was the first woman in history to share my fate. To be married to an Emperor Ryu. But... She's not like me at all. Nothing at all. She's a monster. Yeah. Yeah, she is. She's the one who's responsible for all that. What a horrible, awful, loathsome, terrible person. I hate her. My family might have been cruel, but at least they were ignorant. A woman like Hyun-ae couldn't possibly have any sort of excuse. I really, really, really hate her. So do I. Okay, well... How much more do we have? Wait, does this show... 21 unextracted files. Okay, so there's 21 unextracted files. Well, there's obviously a lot more to this story. So that's not the end of it. But, unfortunately... It's time to go to bed and wait until tomorrow. Okay. Power down until tomorrow should give me the option to save, right? Are you sure you want to shut down for today? Hold on. Very well, take your time, just let me know when you're ready. Let me just double check. No messages, all my power's used up, yeah. Alright, power down. Yep. Very well, I'll just let you go ahead and save your data first. Thank you. Done. All done. Well, good night. Good night to you too, Hyun-ae. It's been a really exhausting day, hasn't it? Well, see you tomorrow. It has been. You know, there's something very strange. There's something strangely... There's something very strange about the design decision to make it so you actually have to wait real-world time till you can come back. Whether it's a good idea or not, I don't know, but I have to say, having it so that when she says, well, see you tomorrow, and that's actually the real-world truth, I literally will have to wait till tomorrow to see her and come back, that creates a strange sort of connection. It creates like a... I can't say it any other way. A connection to the... A strange sort of connection to the game in a way that I've never had. I've never had a game actually be connected to me by time. Like this. Where in the game world, you have to wait time, and you have to wait the same amount of time in the real world. That's... It's very strange, but... It's oddly powerful. Like, well, see you tomorrow. That actually means something. Like, in a normal game, that would be, okay, you press see you tomorrow, the screen fades to black, it comes back, and it's the next day. But no. It is literally tomorrow. It's a fascinating design choice. I really am fascinated by it. Okay. Alright. See you tomorrow, Hyun-ae. Good night. End of day 2. 12 hours remaining until tomorrow. Achievement unlocked, the death of Old Mute. Okay, well folks, that was the end of day 2. So, when I come back, we will of course start the next day and see what the heck is in store for us then. Alright, I hope you have enjoyed so far, and I will be back soon.